No question, there is a ton to do while you're in Charleston, whether you're visiting or you live here. My name is Brandon Bott, and I'm your Charleston real estate guy, and I want to go over a little bit about the best and worst things that you can do while being in or visiting Charleston. I think first off, the absolute best thing you can do is go to one of the beach towns. Again, go to Sullivan's Island, where they have amazing food, 4 or 5 different restaurants. Honestly, my wife and I's absolute favorite is Obstinate Daughter on Sullivan's Island, where, you know, it takes you a month or two to get a reservation, but the food is out of this world. And not only Obstinate Daughter, but you have restaurants like Home Team, Poe's Burger Joint. You have a new restaurant out there, not new, I guess you can say, Co-op, great restaurant. So you have a ton of different restaurants, but it's also at the beach, which is freaking awesome. So Sullivan's Island is a great place to visit. Beach, great restaurants, overall great experience. And then you have Isle of Palms, a little more touristy. So you're gonna have resorts out there. You have a ton of golf, great activity if you're looking to kind of have everything in one place where you really don't even have to leave the beach to go into downtown Charleston or do anything, I highly recommend Isle of Palms. This is a great area for golfing, for kayaking, restaurants, the list goes on. Isle of Palms is a fantastic area for doing pretty much everything. And then you have Kiwa Island, very popular. Obviously, they have the PGA tour there some years. Kiwa Island is about 20, 30 minute drive from downtown Charleston, where great beaches, great restaurants, amazing golf. If you're a golf buff, then you know everything you already need to know about Kiowa. Great courses out there, very difficult courses that if you don't want to lose a lot of balls, I don't recommend playing if you're not a great golfer, but go out there and have fun anyway. You have Folly Beach, which is a lot more laid back area. Ton of really cool restaurants out there, great vibes, great for surfing. Folly Beach is kind of the place to go for surfing. That's where all the locals go to surf at least. So each beach in Charleston or on the outskirts of Charleston have a little bit different things to offer, but all of them are great. All of them, you're gonna have a great time at. You're gonna be able to get great food. You're gonna be able to have fun doing great activities, so on and so forth. So I say that's the top thing that I would do when coming to Charleston or living in Charleston. Second, I'd say shopping and bar hopping. For all you ladies out there, if you're looking to go shopping, go downtown, go to King Street and just bop around, right? There's pretty much every store you could possibly want. Now, this is in New York City, don't get me wrong, but Charleston has great opportunities for you to go shopping and bar hopping, grab a mimosa. There's a ton of great spots to get brunch downtown. Five Church is awesome, right on Market. Go to Grill 225, go to the rooftop. There's a ton of rooftop bars downtown Charleston that will give you a great view of the Ravenel Bridge, Mount Pleasant, the Battery. So if you're looking to have fun and you're looking to go downtown and experience a whole downtown thing, grab some drinks while you're at it. Bar hop, go on King Street and just enjoy walking down King Street and hitting different bars. If it was me, honestly, that's what I'm doing. So great overall fun there. I'd say third, if you're in Mount Pleasant, go to Shem Creek. I live in Mount Pleasant and Shem Creek is one of the most fun places you could possibly go in all of Charleston, in my opinion. A lot of people drive into Mount Pleasant and hit Shem Creek. There's great restaurants that are literally right on the water. You have Red's Ice House, Tavern and Table, probably my wife and I's top 5 restaurant in all of Charleston. Great food there. Saltwater Cowboys, all of these restaurants are literally on Shem Creek and give you a great view of the intercoastal, and some places even give you a great view of downtown, which is really cool. A really cool experience. You'll see dolphins kind of going through. So overall, just a really fun place to go, fun place to get drinks. Very, how can I say it, melting pot crowd. It's not super young, not super old. It's just a great mix. It's kind of where everybody goes in Mount Pleasant. So I definitely recommend hitting Shem Creek and enjoying some drinks and watching the sunset for sure. And then if you're a history buff, downtown is extremely vast in its history, right? You have the Battery, which is a ton of very historical homes. If you've ever visited here, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Downtown, especially on the Battery, has a ton of homes that are hundreds and hundreds of years old. Really cool architecture, cobblestone roads, and amazing views. Definitely recommend parking, jumping out, and walking around the Battery. It's a really cool experience, and highly recommend that. And then Charleston is obviously known for not only the beach, not only the great weather, but their food, right? Downtown has an absolute amazing list of fantastic restaurants that really can hit any kind of taste bud. If you're looking for a great steakhouse, recommend Hall's Chop House. Tough to get in, but once you get in, it's a great experience. But the list goes on with amazing restaurants downtown, from Hall's to, if you're looking for a great burger point, hit Little Jack's Tavern. Great Italian restaurant called Vincent Chico's. Food is not going to be an issue when it comes to visiting Charleston. Really any area, even outside of Charleston, Mount Pleasant, Somerville, James Island, John's Island, there's great food all over the place. I don't want to sound biased towards Charleston, but there's really not too many bad things you can do in Charleston. Definitely recommend not getting on I-20 26 or 526 after 2 or 3 p.m. Anybody that lives here will tell you that it's absolute mayhem, but with any high populated area, you're gonna see traffic. It's really just going at the right time. Other things that I wouldn't recommend doing is driving down King Street late at night. They either block it off, or obviously it's a college town too, College of Charleston here, so there's just a ton going on. It's really bad traffic and not super fun to try to drive through. Any other worst things? I'd say, no, there's not too many other things that I don't recommend doing while you're here. Most importantly, get out to the beach, go bar hopping downtown, get some really good food at really any place downtown that's gonna offer great food, and then go play golf, go to the beach, so on and so forth. All right, take care.